corporate social responsibility is a word which is being used in almost every business entities, corporate world. But if we look towards another perspective, that besides the voluntary commitment or imposed by law, or the practices ensured by corporates as a CSR separately department, ancient India has morally been already given the principle of giving back to the society what we receive from the society. So I would include CSR from the perspectives of the past twin concept in Indian scriptures and the concept of charity even in Bhagavad Gita. The first thing, the concept of five threads, last thing. Every individual is indebted to Devrin, Pitruvrin, Rishivrin, Nrivrin and Bhutrin. Now coming to the Devrin, we Indians generally believe that Vayu Devta, Agni Devta, Prithvi Devta. So why do we worship them in the form of deities? Because we believe that preserving them for ourselves and to give it to the future generations in a well-defined position is our duty. So when we talk about Devrin, and if we compare this, relate it to the corporates, that corporates also today believe in the concept of sustainable environment, waste management, recycling, using solar energy, wind energy, reducing the harm on environment. So all these things are related with this modern principle of ancient India in this way. The second concept is Pitruvrin. Pitruvrin, we believe that we follow the legacy of our ancestors and we preach it to our future generations. So similarly, in corporates, the legacy of the owners or the founders of the company can be propagated, can be followed for the concept of well-being of society, as the famous concept of Jamshedji Tata, he believes that the giving back to the society. So this principle of Jamshedji Tata is still followed by Tata Company, and it is one of the top leading companies doing CSR activities. Second is Rishirin. Now we used to believe that what we inherit from our sages, from our teachers, we have to propagate their wisdom to others. So in the same way, the philosophies of great ideals or something which, for example, I could give you of Swapnil Kamath, who has started a startup for training the corporate professionals. So this concept that the professionals have to be trained, he has incorporated a separate organization for training the corporate employees. So that the ideals which a corporate employee has to follow are teach to them. And we believe in human harmony. Now how this the indebtedness towards people can be used, that in organizations we can work for welfare of our employees, we can treat them ethically, we can follow fair labor practices. And lastly is Bhutrin, maintaining harmony between flora, fauna, the food chain, not harming the environment, having a balance between greenery, or if we are using the land for our business purposes, then many organizations such as ITC and all, in order to give back or in order to balance whatever they have had, they have started helping the farmers in converting the wastelands into arable lands. Coming to Bhagavad Gita and the concept. In Bhagavad Gita, there are three provisions of Sattvic Dham, Rajasic Dham and Tamasic Dham. The Sattvic Dham, we can relate it as a philanthropy, that giving something to the needy. Rajasic Dham, that we give donations, but we also want return in something. That along with betterment of society, we wish indeed in return profit for our organization. Then Tamasic Dham, just for compliance that we have to do, that it is in law and we have to follow it. Sattvic Dham, the philanthropy concept. Many organizations we usually say, such as Billas, Tatas, who serve the society, do something for the betterment of society without respecting anything in return, expecting anything in return. These donations can be in the field of art, education, such as many organizations have adopted rural villages, serving for the education of poor child, underprivileged child, etc. then practice exam, which can be compared to the strategic CSR, that strategically the corporate event sponsorships or political sponsorships or Infosys founder Narayan Murthy believes that CSR is for enhancing the shareholders' value. They serve for the betterment of society, but in return, they want their projects to be implemented. So this concept also some organizations are following. Then Tamasic Dan, just to abide by the law that is being enforced in the law, so we have to follow the practices we have to give to the society, then they don't consider it that they are giving to someone needy or not. And triple bottom line, we talk about people, planet and profit. So we can also compare this to the Indian perspective that for people, it means we are doing something for our employees, our customers who are involved with us, planet for sustainable practices, for not harming our planet, then profit, which can be compared to Rajasic Dham, because we indeed expect the profit from the activities undertaken by us. So in respect of people, planet and profit, we can also talk about participation of employees for the progress of the planet and prosperity of all.